I'm Pusha P. I'm capital P. I write the president. What's up, y'all? It's me, TikTok, and this is basically what I am doing today. I am watching YouTube vlogs and laying in my bed. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe on this video, and let's get into it. Y'all, my husband just went in, brought all this right here to my bed, Do y'all understand what is about to take place? I'm finna eat, baby. People want to know how I stay strong, how I'm staying strong. Don't y'all mind the makeup. I've been crying and called myself playing the makeup for one of my videos, and this is the outcome. But y'all already know TikTok goes in on makeup. But I have not just been laying around. I did wake up very late today. And so my husband made a very, very big breakfast, lunch. Shoot, it was almost into dinner time. If you want to ask me, we woke up at 3:20 p.m. But I want y'all to know that I am okay. I thought I would be in worse shape than I'm in, but I am literally a lot stronger at 49 years old than I was at my younger age when my mom passed. I was still 40-something, but I'm just saying younger age. I miss my baby. The house is way too quiet. Let me take these glasses off. The house is way too quiet. Way too quiet. Here in the house, we have the 12-year-old and the 18-year-old. Keep in mind, both which are very, very mature. So it's not like, even though we can baby the 12-year-old sometime too, we're not trying to take Seven's place at all. We all know that he is irreplaceable. I decided to stay in the house the entire weekend. Not sure if that's a good idea or a bad idea because my mind wanders way too much when I'm at home. But I also wanted to give my daughters time to, you know, and there's one of my daughters FaceTiming me now, but she's going to have to wait a minute. I wanted to give my daughters time by themselves to, you know, mourn. They so worried about me and my husband. I had to let them mourn. Hold on, y'all. Okay, so back to what I was saying. I had to let them mourn. Give them time to, you know, do things around their house. And if they have to go grocery shopping, you know, do with the things that they need to do. And not, I don't want them to think that, oh, we have to cheer mama up. We got to cheer my daddy up. No. We got to make sure my little brothers are okay. And they do that all the time, but they need time for themselves also. And I understand that. So, yeah, let me hold the camera up here. I always hold the camera in weird spots. Let me try something different. Okay, that's cool. So, anyway, I love that little sign. Keep it simple. It's very simple. My baby be doing construction literally all day. When my daughter spent the night, they was like, mama, ooh, I see what you mean. He be down there working 24/7. Like him and my husband, they stay up all night. So now I've picked up this little thing with staying up all night. I went to bed at 5 o'clock this morning. My husband went to bed about 7 o'clock this morning. So we did not wake up till 3:20. Like I said, the boys, they stay up all night anyway. But we're going to get through this. We are definitely going to get through this. We're not going to walk around here, you know, mourning, all that type of stuff. But yeah, this is what's going on at my bedside. I have 3 bottles of water. Well, 4, a soda, tissues from crying, my food that I already finished eating, my ring light. Story of my life. I always got something sitting next to my bed so I can pile junk up on it. Oh, yeah, can't forget my gum. I don't smoke, I don't drink, but I do chew gum. I keep asking myself, like, what next? Like, what next? What next? What next? But I'm going to trust God, y'all. And I'm not going to be sitting up here worrying and having my guards up for what may come next. You know, it's God's plan. Whatever happens, any situation is always going to be God's plan. This pillow that I'm laying on is literally a pillowcase with two shirts in it. One happens to be the baby shirt that been in there. This is just, I always make me little things like this and I get comfortable with them. I cry if I cannot find this pillow. Like, my kids will tell you, it's sick. My husband will tell you, he didn't got cussed out behind this pillow so many times, because what he has done is, like, when I leave, he be done let seven take all my stuff out the pillowcase, things like that. I wish he was here to take the stuff out the pillowcase now, but I know he in heaven with my mama. But I'm gonna be all right, y'all. I work from home, so I have not been in my office in over 3 months anyway, so I'm sure I probably won't be going back in my office no time soon, but I will be working right here from the bed, because, yeah, and my baby will be home safe in his room tomorrow. We go pick the baby up at 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. I'm still not sure how to process that, how I'm going to feel about it. I did ask the boys if they were going to be okay with him being in his room. You know, like, would that bother them? Would it freak them out? Back in the day, I wouldn't dare be up for nothing like this. But this is my baby. And I just felt like he needed to be home with us, safe. My baby never been away from us. So these few days, I might sound crazy, but I ain't crazy. I know he not in that jar. It's just his ashes, his remains. But I still feel like he'll be safe at home instead of, you know, being buried somewhere. So, it's a lot to think about and process, y'all, a lot. But we're going to process it. We're going to get through it. I'm going to insert a couple of videos of him here. And, yeah, thank y'all for tuning in. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. Don't just come over here and watch the video. Don't just see the link and not watch the video. Like, I don't really understand what be wrong with people. Like, it's a click of your finger to watch, support, and yeah.
Set up, bitch.
Call your daddy. Can you get it real good? Call daddy. Only one God. That's our God. God. There's no one like you. First. Who can touch like you? Yeah. Or heal us like you do? We stumble and we stray. Push a P. I'm pushing P. I'm capital P. I write the president.